गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
हैप्पी नवरात्रि मैम।
हैप्पी नवरात्रि टू ऑल ऑफ यू।
हैप्पी नवरात्रि।
यस,
हैप्पी नवरात्रि।
सो एज यू ऑल नो दैट वी हैव डन विद द चैप्टर 9 एंड सीईटी इज आल्सो डन, बट आई रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू प्लीज रिवाइज द चैप्टर 9 अगेन आल्सो एट होम। एनी प्रॉब्लम आस्क मी इन द क्लास, because I have noted that you, many of you score very less marks. Ekansh, Twisha, Daksh, Patel, Nishika, Gunnar, Vivan, Balchandani, turn on your camera and sit in the class.
Ma'am.
Sorry. Ma'am.
Yes, Lakshya.
Dad, I'm end of your class, ma'am. Mother wants to talk to you.
Okay. So,
ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, in the Google form there was a question of cube. Ma'am, in that the answer was 27, but the answer should come 54.
Can you have 3x3 cube?
Yes, ma'am.
Can
ma'am,
you
please?
I have a doubt, but now it is solved because one cube is means 3 sides.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. I also understood right now.
How many? You count the cubes, number of cubes in that?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8,
9,
10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17,
18. Again, you are, you know, what are you doing? The line which you have already counted, you are counting it again.
Ma'am, can I count?
Ma'am, if you ask that,
and there is length multiplied by breadth multiplied by height formula is also there to find this. Yes,
I don't have a cube, so simple, ma'am. It is very simple. A cube has 6 sides multiplied by 9 because cube has every side 9. So 9 multiplied by 6 is equal to 54. So
I'm
54.
Ma'am, can I answer?
No.
27.
Please take the cube and start counting the cubes. Length mein 3 hai, breadth mein bhi 3 hai, height mein bhi 3 hai. So it will give you 27.
Ma'am, if you ask that how many squares are there, then it will be 54.
Yes, but we are counting how many cubes are there.
So it will be.
I think it will be 32.
Ma'am. Yes.
Ma'am.
You got these are cubes. Wait. You, Ayush, you got the answer, Ayush?
Ma'am, these are not cubes.
Ma'am. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here. So these are the cubes counted. Now again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh wait.
There are layers of 9.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, there are 3 layers of 9. Wait. Yes, ma'am. I think I'm understanding. 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 layers of 9 means 3 sevens are 27.
Yeah, 3
nines
are 27.
Ma'am, 3
cubes, 9
threes are 9 and 9 threes are 27. Yes. Ma'am, actually I learned square root and cube root like yesterday, and so I
got it. Can I move to the next?
Number 2. Yes, ma'am.
Ayush,
ma'am, 20.
There are...
Yes, ma'am, there are 27 only.
Ayush, you do one
ma'am,
thing.
1, 2,
you
3.
You come, stay at last. I will talk to you.
Okay. Ma'am,
can I move to the next now? No, I cannot see you, Twisha. I cannot see you.
Ma'am, you can pin my another device. I just removed all the pieces and counted.
Okay. See how practically she is doing. Yes. But there is a formula, bacha, length, breadth, and height when you multiply. Suppose if you take 2 by 2 cube. So 2 by 2 cube is having how many? 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8 will be the answer.
Yes, ma'am, I understood.
Okay.
Got it. So, can I move to the next topic now? Next chapter? Please stop, Tuisha. Mute one of the device. Yes. So, the chapter is chapter number 10. The name of the chapter is, what is the name of this chapter?
Ma'am, the name of the chapter is 10, 100.
Very good. When one child speaks, no, the others have to listen. Tens and hundreds. Tens, Aryaman, you have not given your assessment. You were not there in the class yesterday.
Yes, Aryaman, ma'am.
And one more child was absent yesterday.
Ma'am, because there was a puja, that's why I couldn't join.
My dear, sometime you have puja, sometime you have something else, sometime this is happening every day with you. Many times you told that there was a puja at my home. That's the reason I could not join.
Ma'am, but there was a puja yesterday because yesterday was Amavasya on the morning. So even I did the puja.
But
I still attended the classes.
Yes,
also.
For you too, it is compulsory to attend the classes also. Tens and hundreds. Tens and hundreds, do you know what are we going to learn in this chapter?
Ma'am, we are going to learn units and we are going to know numbers and numbers like ones, tens, hundreds, thousands,
ten thousands.
And we might
also learn about,
and we might also learn about how to count the
measuring.
Ma'am, we will learn about place value.
We are going to learn about the place value. Okay, we are going to learn about the place values, but we are going to learn about the decimal places also.
Place value.
Because you know about ones, tens, hundreds, right? This is the place value. But what do you know about what is tens? Why THS is coming? Hundreds. Tens, hundreds, thousands. THS is coming. This you have learned. You know, last chapter we have done about the fractions also.
Yes, ma'am. In the fourth grade, we learned the numbers of ones, tens, hundred, thousand, international system, Indian system. We learned this base also, this chapter only.
So this chapter is basically based on the decimals. Suppose I'm giving you any number. First of all, I'll tell you the rule of the decimals. Then I will ask from you all. Right? Suppose you get this rupees 35.25. What does this mean? Yes, Freya.
Thank you, nice.
Ma'am, it means that 35 rupees and 25 paisa.
35 rupees and 25 paisa. And 25 paisa is having a relation of 100 because 1 rupee is equals to 100 paisa. So 25 paisa is a part of how many paisas? 100 paisa.
100.
So if I tell you, write this into the fraction. So how you will write it into the fraction, the 25 paisa? Only 25 paisa?
25 upon 100.
25 upon 100. So in this chapter, the relation which we are going to learn of the decimal with rupees, with lengths, meter and centimeters, with capacity. So we are going to learn decimal because decimal aapko sab mein milta hai, kilogram, gram mein bhi hota hai. Sometimes you say, I bought 7.500. This means what? 7 kg, 500 grams. So yes. 500 grams is having a relation with how many? What will come in the fraction?
Ma'am, it could be 7,500 gram also.
Yes, it could be 7,500 grams also. And if I tell you, write the 500 grams only in the fraction, how you will write?
500 gram.
500 divided by 1,000.
500 upon.
Because
500 with 1 kilogram is
1,000 grams. 1 kg is 1,000.
So now we are going to learn about the place value. Now you take out your notebook, take pencil in your hand, and draw the place value chart in your notebook. See, students.
Understand what you taught.
You understood or not?
No, ma'am, I didn't.
First,
understand.
You will understand the place value chart, that I will make you understand more. Okay. So take out your notebook, take pencil eraser in your hand, and you will draw the place value chart in this way. Sleeping. Got it?
I'm the notebook. Ma'am, I had understand.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
The horizontal.
Yeah. So write place value chart.
Ma'am, Indian system.
I'm telling you, no? Decimal place value chart. Decimal place value chart.
Ma'am, my book was torn, so I give the book in binding.
Notebook for the binding.
Ma'am, sorry, ma'am, textbook.
I'm telling you to draw in the notebook.
Okay, okay.
Textbook, so ma'am, you don't have place.
Remove your textbooks and pencil eraser.
Text. I said remove your notebooks and take pencil and eraser in your hands to draw this.
And we have to make this standing only.
Sleeping. Because you will not get, if you make like me, you will not get the space. There are two parts of a decimal place value. One is left and one is right side. Left side is the whole part. We will call it whole part. Then the decimal will come. And then the fractional part will come. This is called decimal part. D-E-C-I. So this is decimal point. Right side will be the decimal part and left side will be the whole part. Suppose I say, and this is ones. You all know this is ones, tens, hundreds, H-U-N-D-R-E-D-S, hundreds, thousands. But if decimal is coming, so the right side after the decimal, Karnav, I told you to draw in the notebook. The right side after the decimal will be, there will be no ones. Is always
ma'am, it will be tens.
Tens. Yes. Always tens, start from the
thousands. Tens, hundreds, thousands.
Yes.
Like that.
Thousands. T-H-O-U-S-A-N-D-S, thousands.
Ma'am, I left the meeting, so
whatever I am drawing here on the board, please draw in your notebook.
I had left my internet issue.
Draw in your notebooks.
Remember, I didn't understand decimal part and whole part.
This is whole, the simple place value chart, you know, ones, tens, hundred, thousand. So this is ones, tens, hundred, thousand. There are two parts in the decimal. One is left side and the other is right side. And in the middle, there is a decimal point. After decimal point towards the right side, it start the decimal numbers. And the places are tens, hundreds, tens, hundreds, sorry, hundreds will come here. Thousands. THS. Write the spelling of thousand and then write THS. Write the spelling of 100, write THS. Write the spelling of 10, write THS. Tens. There is no ones part in this decimal point. And but when you go to the normal whole part, is always start from the ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, and so on. This is the difference between the decimal. I'm not rubbing. This is the what I say is difference between the normal place value chart and the decimal place value chart. The decimal place value chart, the decimal part always start from the tens.
Ma'am, but yes. Why is it different? Ma'am, we write tens once at the last. In this, you have written in the first.
Yes. Here it's right. Start from this side towards going this side. And here the tens, hundreds start from this side. Because when the fractional part is coming, suppose 1 upon 10, you
say. Yes, ma'am.
Out of the total parts, we are talking about the one part. 1 upon 100 means we are talking about the one part out of the total 100 parts. Got it?
Ma'am, after what you have written in the right side of decimal part?
Ones, this side.
Yes.
Ma'am, I'm not able to understand.
I said just to draw. Then you will understand in a better way.
Ma'am, we have to not write inside it.
No. Write tens, hundreds, and thousands only.
Tens. Ma'am, so behind side also I have written ones, tens, hundred, thousand. And tens.
Here is ones, tens, hundreds.
Ma'am, we have to write four thousands.
We will have to write whole part and decimal part.
Yes, you have to write whole part and then put a decimal and write towards the right side. This is the decimal part.
Thousands. Ma'am, done.
Drawing part is done. Then learn and go to the explanation part.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, we have to write whole part and decimal part.
Yes. Now I'm going to show you one video also so that you can better understand. Please mute yourself. Someone mic is on. Done, everyone, so that I go to the video.
Yes, ma'am.
Now yes, mute ma'am. Yourself, everyone. I'm also going to mute myself. And then you please understand. Any doubt, ask me after the video.
Okay, ma'am.
What is a tenth? We can draw a rectangle to represent one whole. We can then divide the rectangle into 10 equal parts. Colouring one of the 10 parts gives us the fraction 1/10. We can also write 1/10 as the decimal number 0.1. We can show 1/10 on a place value chart. There are 0 ones and 1/10. Write as a decimal. The whole has been divided into 10 equal parts, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of the parts are coloured. 6 tenths are coloured. We can also write this as the decimal 0.6. We can show 6 tenths on a place value chart. There are 0 ones and 6 tenths. Write as a decimal. Here we have one whole and 8 tenths. 1 and 8 tenths are coloured. We can write this.
So children, when you have learned in the fraction about the mixed fraction, 2 whole, 6 upon 10, right? This way you have learned or not? So how you are going to write it into the mixed fraction, the mixed fraction into the decimal? So this they are going to explain you, listen it properly.
Write as a decimal. The whole has been divided into 10 equal parts, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of the parts are coloured. 6 tenths are coloured. We can also write this as the decimal 0.6. We can show 6 tenths on a place value chart. There are 0 ones and 6 tenths. Write as a decimal. Here we have one whole and 8 tenths. 1 and 8 tenths are coloured. We can write this as the decimal 1.8. 1.8 has 1 1 and 8 tenths. Write as a decimal. The red arrow is pointing to a number on the number line between 13 and 14. Each step on the number line shows 1 tenth. Let's count on from 13.5. 13.5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The red arrow is pointing to the decimal 13.9. 13.9 has 1 10, 3 ones, and 9 tenths.
Now you understood?
Yes, ma'am, very clearly.
Now I will explain you here also in the on the board. Suppose I give you this fraction 6 upon 10. You have learned this? Yes, now I tell you, convert this fraction into the decimal. Four students left the class. Who all are these four students?
And 0.6.
Yes, let me take the attendance for a minute. Because when you write ones place, when you write the place values ones and tenths, in the tenths place value six will come, decimal point will come at its own place, and nothing is here in the whole numbers. If nothing is there, if I write two, so here what will come?
Two
in the ones place. But if nothing is there in the whole numbers, so we write nothing here in the whole numbers, we write 0.6, and it is having tenths at the denominator, so 6 will come under the tenths. Suppose if you have 26 upon 10, then what you will do in this case? How you will write the decimal? So once, this is a fractional part, nothing is in the whole, nothing is in the whole, it is 2, 26, then where you are going to put the decimal?
0.26.
Suppose there is 100, then what you will do?
The two zeros will come.
No, there are two 0.26. There are two zeros. Count the two digits from the back. This is 26, 6 and 2, and then put the decimal.
So, ma'am, decimal is counting a type of a number only.
Yes, suppose, yes, you need to count that many. The zeros are there, two zeros are there. So, after the two digits, with the decimal you will put. Suppose it's 1,000. Then what you will do? And you have two digits in the numerator. What you will do? Yeah. How you are going to put the decimal?
We'll add a zero.
You have 1,000 as a denominator, but you have two places only in the numerator. What are you going to do? You add zero where?
Zero to
last. No, not last. Before.
Ma'am, before zero.
2, 0, point, nothing is in the one stands, so it will be like this. Got it? So to make the three digits, we need to write add 1, 0 in the beginning, not at the last.
Okay.
Clear, everyone?
Yes.
So now there is the, in your textbook, what was the length of the smallest pencil you have? Use one long pencil in this. Guess how many centimeter it is. So take the scale. Take scale and start measuring. Start measuring this pencil.
Ma'am, 14 centimeter.
14 centimeter.
Ma'am, 9 centimeter.
I don't think so, bacha.
Ma'am, this is 9 centimeter.
Which pencil? Your pencil, okay. Now here, the pencil which is there in the textbook. Take scale and measure that pencil.
Ma'am, it's 3.5.
It is 3.
Yes, ma'am. It is 3.5.
Yes, ma'am.
And if I want to write it into the fraction, how will I write?
Ma'am, 3/5.
3/5.
3/5.
3.5. No, how you are going to write the fraction for this 5?
3/10, ma'am.
5/10.
5/10.
Only the decimal part will be converted into the fraction.
Yes, ma'am.
Only the decimal part will be converted. This is the whole 3 centimeter.
Yes, ma'am.
5/10. So the place value of this 5 is tens. Yeah, everyone.
Yes,
because
ma'am.
Out of the total, because 1 centimeter equals to 10 millimeter, right? So out of the total 10 parts, you are talking about the 5 parts. So 5/10. Clear? 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. So out of the total 10 millimeter, we are talking about the 5. Same if I talk in the rupees. So how you will write the fraction for this 35? We are talking about here how many? 1 rupee is equals to, you know the relation, 1 rupee, 1 equals to 100 paisa. So what will come in the denominator? This 35 paisa is a part of how many paisa?
35/100.
Yes.
35/100.
Got it, everyone? So that is why. And the 5 is 100.
Ma'am, 45.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, 45.
You know why the 3 is tens and the 5 is hundreds? Because we are talking about here the 100 paisas. Yes. Clear the place value now?
Ma'am,
yes, ma'am.
There will be the 45 will be gone.
There will be, this is the whole 45 rupees. But only the decimal part can be converted into the fractional part.
Okay.
And you understood about the places, why they are 35, because here they are, the relation is with
them. Because that is tens and that is 100.
why this is tens and hundred? Because here the 1 rupee equals to 100 paisa. So the place
is there. There is 180 rupees. It is written down.
Where?
Right, you have written a 180 down.
Not written. I written rupee 1 equals to 100 paisa.
I'm talking about the above one. Oh, understood. It is written 100, but because of P, yes. I could see 180.
Now clear the place values, tens and hundreds. Why hundreds yes, are coming? Ma'am. Because the other relation is with the 100. Yes, got ma'am. It? Okay, suppose ma'am. If I go with the 1 kg equals to 1000 grams. So if I say 25 upon 1000. And now you have converted into the fraction. Can you convert yes, it into ma'am. The decimal?
Yes, ma'am. 25.
Yes, ma'am.
Point.
Yes, ma'am. Animal. Can you convert it into the decimal? Can you convert this fraction into the decimal? Yes, Priya.
Ma'am, it's, Priya, ma'am, it's 20, before 25, there will be a zero, and before zero, it will be a decimal.
Zero of the this place value and 0, 2, 5 will be the answer. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
How to write the decimal? Very clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Why I'm adding zero here? Because you need to write till thousands. Because your thousand yeah. is your denominator.
So before, you have add zero before after before 25 because it is thousand.
Because this is 25 grams. If you yeah. add the zero after 25, it will become 250 grams.
Yeah, but it is here 25 grams.
25 grams. So that is why to add it up to the 1000 place value, we add the zero in the beginning.
Okay, ma'am.
And write the fraction into the decimal.
And can I give you the any example and answer?
Yes. Yes, please.
Yeah, ma'am. If it is 45 upon 1000.
So how you will write it in the decimal?
Yeah, we will write 0.045.
Very good. And now you know when decimal is there, we cannot say this is 45. We never read the numbers which are after the decimal. We cannot read them together. We read them single. 0, 4, 5. Okay, if it is 7, 9, 5, whatever. If this 3-digit or if it is 2-digit, you cannot say it is 79.
Yeah, we can only
7, 9, 5. After the decimal, we read the digits as a single digits. Right? Clear, everyone? Clear or not?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So today, you know what I'm going to send you? I'm going to send you a worksheet where you will see, suppose this is one box divided into 100 equal parts, or this, suppose this is 100 equal parts. Out of 100 equal parts, I have shaded 20 parts. So how I will write the fraction for the shaded part? Suppose total are 100, you shaded 20. Right now, I cannot make the total 100 and it will be difficult for me.
Ma'am.
So if I tell you, write the fraction for the shaded part. So how you will write?
20 upon 100.
And if I tell you, write the decimal for this now after making the fraction.
Yeah, ma'am. We will write
0 upon 20.
0 upon 20.
Fraction mein upon to nahi aayega.
0.20.
This is the fractional, this is the decimal.
Yeah.
Clear, everyone? Trisha, mute yourself. Your one mic is on.
Ma'am, my mother's want to talk to you.
Yes, please. Wait a minute. Call her, I will talk. So are you all clear? Today I'm going to send you the worksheet like this, where you see the shaded part, write the fraction of that, and convert it into the decimal also.
Ma'am, in the worksheet, okay. There is okay, a number line also.
No, no number line. Only the blocks will come. You write the fraction for the shaded part and write the decimal for that. Clear, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, oh, ma'am.
Now you
yes,
ma'am. Leave the ma'am. Class. Thank you, students. Ma'am, wait a minute. Lakshya, wait, please.